Good evening, students. A warm welcome to all of you. I know all of you have been eagerly waiting for this CSAP process, seat allotment process. So how to proceed further in choosing the best branch available? Because today every student is thinking only computer science people are having good opportunities and all. You are wrong. Each and every branch is having equal opportunities. Do not get into the dilemma. Only there is a logical boom. People think, usually get confused between technology means it's only computer science. Every branch using technology, and every branch is using technology and having lot more opportunities, developments, research is happening. So all of you are today eagerly waiting to know what branch I will be getting in CSAP, what are the guidelines you need to be following during the CSAP and all. So I will be giving you a brief idea about how to choose this engineering branch based on the opportunities, because choosing an engineering branch is very vital. Just because some of your relatives told that branch is having opportunities more, like CSC is having more opportunities, or you read somewhere or somebody told you that only CS people are having jobs, do not get into that kind of mode or that kind of dilemma. So I will be giving you a brief about what are the major courses you will be handling in each engineering stream which we are offering. I am only talking about the branches which we are offering in Amrita, and what are the opportunities, or that means career prospects. So what kind of jobs you can do after completing this, and what kind of companies. I won't be naming all the companies which are in that sector, just to give an idea, because lot more people just think about entering into computer science. They won't think about the end point, where you want to go. So defining a goal today for all of you who are entering this UG undergraduate space is very much important. So all of you need to do is proper planning right now. Because this is a crucial step for you. It's a step forward for your future. So all of you need to be very well prepared, very well aware of the opportunities of each and every branch. So today's session is mainly about that. After giving you an idea about this engineering branches, I will also give some guidelines regarding the seat allotment process and all. So let's start with the presentation today, which is choosing the best engineering branch and all. So I hope all of you know about Amrita University. Please watch this video about our university. This is just a brief about our university.
Place where the best minds come together, work towards transforming life. This is a place recognized as one of best universities. This is Amrita, ranked among the top 100 universities in the world and ranked number one in India, Amrita University.
I hope all of you by now know about our university. We have almost 6 campuses spread across 3 states, and our main agenda is today for you to give education for life. Okay, so these are our ranking and accreditations. We are 4th best university, and almost 50% of seats we fill with scholarship. Students, please note this. 50% of seats are filled by scholarship, and we are recognized as institution of eminence by the UGC. The average salary a student who completes UG will get is 6 lakhs per annum. And the highest salary one of our students received in the last academic year is 56.95 lakhs per annum. Almost 95% students are placed. So these 4 campuses are available for all of you right now to choose in the counseling process: Amritapuri, Bangalore, Chennai, and Coimbatore. Okay, so let's get into today's topic. So a lot of you are well aware of this branch, which is computer science and engineering. This is one of the most trending disciplines because everybody is behind this branch or having a huge hype. And to get a small idea what you deal about in this branch is, you will be dealing about or studying about computer programming languages or software development or algorithm designs, so networking, etc. Okay, so if you are in this discipline, you can get into design, you can get into management, you can get into either hardware or you can get into software aspects of it. And there is higher academic opportunities also. You can do M.Tech, you can do PhD in this branch. Okay, the main thing is, of course, all of you know very well about this thing. So the course structure is predominantly in this way. That means data structures you will be studying, how you can utilize that data for the benefit, how we can design new algorithms using the data, how we can get a proper output using the data. That means using the data, can you analyze it and use it for the benefit of developing a new product or come up with a new solution to the problem you are facing. So that kind of things you can do. So data analysis, data structure and algorithms, and one more thing is computer architecture, computer networks, operating systems. All of you know by right now what are the operating systems you are using. Of course, all of you are using Android, so you might be using KitKat or any kind of operating systems you might be using. So if you are having a laptop or using a computer, you might know you are using a Windows or a iOS or Linux. These kind of operating systems are available. You can learn a lot more things about it, and artificial intelligence also will be there, and database systems, computer networks, compiler design and logic design. These are some of the major course structures, but there are a lot more courses also. So what I am telling you is this: if you concentrate well on these courses which I have mentioned, there will be huge scope in the coming future. Okay, after completing this computer science and engineering, you can become a software engineer, you can become a software tester, or you can become a mobile application developer, IT administrator or website developer. There are a lot more things to it. I have mentioned only some of the titles only. I have not mentioned full titles of people who are completing computer science and engineering, but people know these companies because these companies will be there in the news 24/7. So if you check Google, Microsoft, Yahoo, Facebook, Amazon, these are some of the big companies, but there are a lot more companies coming up in India. So who hire these people, computer science and engineering people and all. Okay, so, and one more branch is computer science AI, computer science. Okay, so these are the specializations which are available with us. So computer science AI is
branch which is there. So people, you have already attended our sessions, so you know that AI is one of the booming branch, because what is the importance of AI? We have been explaining in the past
webinars and all, and cyber security is very much vital. So that's why we have given two specializations: computer science AI, computer science and cyber security. These are the two branches which are available in Amrita as of now. And one new branch we have implemented in this year, or we have introduced in this year, is automation and robotics, because this is very much in demand branch. There is a huge growth and potential for this branch. Okay, you can deal with subjects from mechanical, electrical, control engineering, computer science, all. There will be a mix of topics in this engineering, but the main thing is you will be able to focus on automation, because today everybody in the manufacturing or either in healthcare, everybody is looking at automation. So because they want to automate the process, they want to reduce the human intervention in every process which we are doing. So we need to understand this. There might be a huge scope in automation and robotics. That's why we have introduced this new branch. So there are a lot more applications to it. If we talk about this, this session won't be enough to complete the applications of this automation and robotics engineering. So what is this program? Objective is to give you knowledge about solving the problem, solving the problems which you are facing, and automate them. So without human intervention and all. Oh, what you need to do is you need to upgrade your technical, intellectual and emotional skills. So this is a lifelong learning. What we are having today is, today you have learned a programming language, so it might be useful for some point of time, then again you need to learn a new programming language. We are at that point now, because whatever branches which are being implemented, whatever specializations we have been implemented today, so these are very much in demand with the corporate world, with the universities today. So that's why you need to understand this branch importance and all. So this is one branch, automation and robotics, which we have implemented. And the next branch is mechanical engineering. So all of you might be knowing about this mechanical engineering. This is one of the oldest discipline. People tend to ignore the opportunities available for a mechanical engineer. there are quite a wide spectrum of opportunities available for mechanical engineers, because they can get into aerospace engineering, because they can they can cross the boundaries. Actually, these people can get into actual multidisciplinary learning. This mechanical engineers, they can either work in designing or they can work in manufacturing, various applications they have. Okay, so the thing is, the main subjects or core concepts, you will be dealing with mechanics, kinematics, thermodynamics. I know you might have studied these things in your plus two also, but you might be dealing in depth of these topics and all. So you can do M.Tech also, or you can do PhD also in this thing. The main thing is you can go for specializations also in mechanical. You can get into automotive, or you can get into robotics or fluid mechanics, thermal science. There are a lot more specializations in mechanical engineering. So these are some of the important core structure, which is machine design, dynamics and of mechanism and machines, fluid mechanics, turbo machinery, IC engines, refrigeration and cooling, manufacturing technology, material science. So these are some of the core structures which you need to consider when you are joining mechanical engineering. People tend to ignore this career options which these people have, because automobile sector is one of the in demand sector in these days. Everybody wants a bike, everybody wants a car, everybody wants an automobile which they can use for travel from one place to another. So there will be continuous demand in automobiles. Okay, so for that automobiles, mechanical engineers are one of the key pillars who design this automobiles and all. So, or you can work in power, or you can work in cement manufacturing, or steel manufacturing, or hydraulics mining. These are the career options you have after completing mechanical engineering. Okay, so as a mechanical engineering, what I'm telling you is you can design, you can analyze, or you can manufacture. These kind of options you have, you can get into either any of these things, or you can get into government engineering services also if you have complete mechanical engineering. Okay, so the companies which you know is very much easy to understand, because DRDO, National Defense Research Organization, and one more thing is Indian Railways also hire mechanical engineers, Reliance Industries, Ashok Leyland. So there's only some of the companies which I am telling you, but there are lots and lot more companies today available and giving opportunities for these people. Okay, the next branch is civil engineering. Civil engineering is one of the least desired group. Actually, I can say people, I don't know why they won't aim for this group. This is one of the oldest discipline. Today's seven wonders are impossible without the civil engineers. Okay, that means there is an evergreen demand for civil engineers. Being a developing country like India, so there is a continuous requirement for infrastructure. So there might be new roads coming, there might be new constructions happening, IT parks, or everybody today, after you have grown to a certain age and earning some money, you want your own house, right? So that means there is a continuous requirement for infrastructure. So, and it's not only construction, maintenance and operation, designing, planning, everything for each and everything related to infrastructure, civil engineers are required. Okay, so it's not about the cost and also. Civil engineers can be involved in infrastructure at any point of time. Okay, you can have opportunities of higher academics also if you are coming into civil engineering. The main thing is you can get into structural engineering, or you can get into bridge engineering, hydraulic engineering. There are a lot more specializations, because today some people are only thinking civil engineering means they can construct houses and all. Civil engineers means they can construct dams, they can handle big projects. It's not civil engineering means, because that kind of mindset we are in, we usually think civil engineers means they are useful for only designing houses and all. But civil engineering scope is very huge. The project they handle is also very huge. If you are doing from a prominent institutes, you will be getting a lot more opportunities as a civil engineer. Okay, so let me get into the major courses which you all will be dealing in civil engineering. Is hydraulics, transport engineering, structural analysis, solid mechanics, transport engineering, design of RC structures, water and wastewater engineering, elements of surveying, all these things. Okay, these are some of the important things. Career options is you can get into a lot more things. You can get into government, or you can work as a private sector, or you can be as a consultant also to a lot more things. These are some of the companies like Larsen & Toubro, and Engineers India Limited, PWT, Indian Railways, DRDO, SCRC and DLF. So these are some of the companies which are available to you. So the next one is Electronics and Communication Engineering, which is that this discipline deals with the development of electronic devices like transistors, printed circuit boards, integrated circuits which are used in computers and all. So this branch is also one of the in demand branch, so a lot more people aim for this branch. So this branch has huge demand also, so you can get into this branch if you are really interested in developing this electronic devices and all, or doing some research or bringing up some innovations in this kind of sector and all. So electronics and communications is also one of the booming sector which you can get into, or booming engineering branch which you can get into. This offers you various courses and specializations also, like embedded system, wireless communication system design. Once you get to know about this electronics and engineering, why I am telling you these details is, when you're making a decision like this, you should be able to understand the opportunities equally about each and every branch, because it's not a small decision. Okay, so you should understand the opportunities. So major courses in electronics and communication engineering is microprocessors and embedded systems, signals and systems, VLSI, digital signal processing, electrical circuits and machines, communication system, optical systems, analog communication, digital communication, antennas and propagation. Okay, this is about electronics and communication engineering. You can work in various career paths, because either you can work in radio and television industry, or we can work in consumer electronics. Consumer electronics means developing this washing machines or TVs or all these consumer electronics which you are talking about. Or you can work in health diagnostic equipments, like the MRI, the scanning equipment, all these things you can work in that also. So you can work in lot more domains if you are getting into this kind of engineering space and all. Okay, popular companies today which we know is BHEL, Bharat Electronics Limited, and Texas Instruments and Samsung Electronics. Lot more companies are there, Sony, Philips Semiconductors, and these are some of the companies which are available for you. And the next branch is electrical engineering. So this is also similar to electronics and communication engineering, but this involves a study of electromagnetism and development maintenance of electrical system. That means high power equipment, that means the transformers or the thermal power stations, power distribution stations, all these things which you will be working on. So this deals with, also there will be a correlation between these both courses, so you can choose the electives wisely so that you can work in both sectors also. So electrical engineers can also work as electronics and communication engineers. It's about the courses which you choose, like if you select signal processing as your major, so then you can work in this electronics and communication also as well. So there might be a similar courses in both these branches and all. What are the major courses which we have talked about is power systems, electrical machines, power generations and signal systems and networks, which we have talked about in the electronics and communications also, and semiconductor device technology, fiber optics. So people doesn't know the importance of semiconductor. A semiconductor is used to design the chips which we use, because people talk about this Intel chip, and people which we are using, how much processor we have and all in your computer and all, the chip is designed, or the material used to design the chip is semiconductor. So that means semiconductor devices will be having a huge demand in the coming days and all. Okay, and microprocessor, microcontroller, DC machines and transformers and all. So these are the career options as an electrical engineer. You can work either in power industry, or you can work in telecommunication also, as I have told, and navigation, railways, automobile, aerospace, defense, etc. Okay, as electricity is an important source, there is a continuous requirement for this also. Please understand that electrical engineering and electronics and communication engineering is one of the in-demand branches as of now. Okay, so Bajaj International Private Limited is one of the company, as I told, BHEL and Siemens, Crompton Greaves, Reliance Power Limited. These are some of the big companies. I am only telling you limited names, because I don't have to give out all the list of companies to that hire electrical engineers and all. Next branch is aeronautical engineering. So aeronautical engineering, almost all of you know about aeronautical engineering. What these people do is, these people can get into development of aircrafts or spacecraft, or do research, or they can get into automation also. Mainly it covers a great part of subjects which we deal in mechanical engineering also. Okay, so this is almost similar to mechanical engineering, but there will be a lot more added on subjects. So that's why I told, if you do mechanical engineering, you can get into aeronautical companies also, or you can get into civil engineering companies also. There's a huge scope for mechanical engineers, which a lot of people don't understand. Okay, so mainly the subjects which you deal with: mathematics, physics, aeronautics, electricity, and robotics, and all. And there is a higher academic opportunity also. You can complete MTech also in this sector, and you can complete PhD also. So these are some of the courses: aerodynamics, aircraft design, space flight mechanics, mechanics, thermodynamics and propulsion, incompressible fluid mechanics, structural mechanics, aerospace propulsion. So these kind of courses which you will be dealing with once you enter into this aeronautical engineering and curriculum and all. So do not think only these are the course names and all. I'm giving you just important topic names so that you will understand. Okay, so these are not the course names. So these are some of the important topics or subjects which you might deal, that names might be changing. Okay, if you have completed aeronautical engineering and all, you can either work in private sector or you can work in government sector. But there is a huge demand of aeronautical engineering in government sector and all, because there are very less people who are entering into aeronautical engineering in government sector and all. That means people who work in ISRO. ISRO is giving lot more opportunities for students who are interested in research and bringing up new innovations using their ideas, because they want intelligent students who can work continuously for the growth and innovation of our country and all. So there are a lot more career prospects available for students who complete aeronautical engineering. As I have told, you can work in civil aviation. That means you can work in private manufacturing aeroplane companies and all, or you can work with ISRO, or you can work with Indian Space Research. That's what I had told. So there are a lot more government sector opportunities for these people who are doing aeronautical engineering and all. Okay, then the next branch is chemical engineering. So a lot more people think chemical engineering people are not in demand and all. You know, the people who are earning more in this pandemic time are chemical engineering people, because these people work in pharmaceutical companies who design and develop the drug, the medicines which we use today. So that's why these people have huge value today. So please understand, chemical engineering people will be having huge demand in the coming future also, because these people work in synthetic fibers, petroleum refineries, pharmaceutical companies and all. Okay, these organic chemistry, chemical reactions engineering, fundamentals of heat and mass transfer, numerical method, pharmaceutical technology and all, industrial problem. These are some of the courses and all. The career prospects is like, you can join these kind of companies and all. I know all of you are eagerly waiting now, because I have given you small details about this branches and all. So now I will move on to the topic which is in demand today. Everybody is asking me, so how I need to register for CSAP, what is the process I need to follow, what branch I will be getting, so what kind of things I need to consider when I am joining Amrita, or when I need to pay the fee, so what is the last date, where I need to check my results. Lot more questions we are facing today. Okay, the thing is, today there are 5 golden rules every student who is participating in CSAP should understand. Okay, we will be updating all the information in amrita.edu/btech. Today every student is claiming, I haven't received an SMS, I haven't received an email. Please visit website regularly, at least in this coming 20 days. Okay, coming 20 days in the sense starting from today, and at least coming 20 days until your classes commence, please keep visiting this website. All the updates about fee structure, about important dates, when we will be announcing the results, when we will be announcing the counseling first allotment results, so every date, every important thing, we are keeping it in amrita.edu/btech. If you read this website carefully in important updates, you will get to know all the information without calling anybody. Okay, and please remember, the process, seat allotment process, is completely online. No need to come to campus. Please avoid coming to the campus. I'm clearly suggesting you all the students do not come to the campus. The process is completely online and the fees, you can pay it online itself. And there will be continuous support and we are flexible enough to give you multiple entries also during this counseling process. It is completely in your favor. Okay, we are giving you more weightage in this allotment process. The first rule which you need to understand is all details are updated in only one page. Please understand again, please do not go here and there in somewhere I read something and all, and some agent is asking me fees and all. No agents are there to collect the fee. No other websites are there to collect the fee, and no other fees we will be asking apart from the fees which we have mentioned in the website to confirm the seat. And all refunds are according to UGC and AICT rules. People are asking me, will I get a refund? Yes, you will be getting the refund according to this UGC and AICT rules. You can just search online about this refund rules of UGC and AICT. You will get to know. Please read that carefully. Okay. And some of the collaborating portals where we can share some information is Careers 360, Get My Uni, Siksha, College Pravesh, Sarvigyan, and Aglasim. All you need to do is, in the first thing you need to do is registering in this CSAP portal. If you have completed registration and paid 5,000, it's very, very good. People who haven't paid this CSAP process yet, you still have the option to pay. You go and pay for the CSAP. Please remember, if you are paying just 2 days before the allotment date only, your data will be considered. I'll give you an example. We have given you on 25th, we will announce first allotment. That means students who have completed their 5,000 payment before 23rd will be considered for seat allotment process. Otherwise, you won't be considered. Okay, then you will be considered for the next round. So for first allotment, you want to participate means you need to complete the payment process prior 2 days prior to that. Okay, so if you really want to complete the CSAP process, or if you want to participate in the CSAP process in the first round itself, complete the payment in this 2 days. That means by today evening or tomorrow evening. Okay, so this is very much vital, students, and it's open now. Please do that. And by tomorrow evening or day after, we'll be publishing the results of trial allotment. This is very much vital because today every student is asking me and calling me and asking me what branch I will get for this rank, what fee slab I need to pay, and will I get CSC? Can you give an idea? So these kind of things every students are asking to know that we have given you a trial allotment, just to give an idea, because people are asking what is based on at least last year ranking, can you tell and all. We can't predict it. That's why we are giving you an option for trial allotment. If you really want to know in trial allotment which branch you will be getting, please complete the payment by today evening itself. Okay, so that 5,000 payment which I have talked about, CSAP payment and all. So how this CSAP works, lot more people have applied through AEEE, JEE, SAT, PUE. So people who have paid using these four options, how we will be doing is, I will give you an example. This student have given your academic preference. This is called academic preference, which I have mentioned in the table. In the right side, you can see your ranks based on each exam which we are allowing. So if you have given Computer Science Chennai, first what we will do is, Computer Science Chennai, you will get using AEEE or not. We will check. Next, if you are not getting, then we will check through JEE you are getting or not. Again, you are not getting, then again we will check through SAT you are getting it or not. Likewise, for every academic preference, we will check each and every rank, through which rank you will be able to get. So it's very easy for you to understand. Today you have written through AEEE and JEE. Through AEEE, we check first your academic preference, are you getting it or not. If you are getting, we will consider AEEE. If not, we will then check JEE. If you are getting through JEE, we will consider that. That is as simple as that. If you are having multiple ranks, there is an added advantage for you because we will be checking both ranks in during the allotment process. Do not think we will be giving you separate seat for JEE and separate seat for AEEE. There will be single seat for both of these things. And students, don't worry, for JEE, we will be announcing a provisional rank because students can still in between can apply during this counseling process. We will be giving you a provisional JEE rank. Maybe by today evening or tomorrow morning, we will release the JEE rank list. So once it is released, you can get an option to view a rank in your AEEE portal, which is very much vital. Application portal is where we post everything. So do not worry about getting SMS or email. Please keep checking your application portal. Your application portal is very much vital during this counseling process. If you have any problem with the application portal, please sort it out before this application process starts. Okay, then the next action is what you need to know is what is this accept confirm, what you see on this slide. Okay, you got an academic preference in fee slab 1. Today you are interested in computer science engineering and your rank is very, very good and you got it in first academic preference and first fee slab. You can accept it by paying the initial fee. Initial fee in the sense you will know when you have been offered the seat, you will know which slab you have been offered. Okay, do not worry about it. And everything which we have talked about will be announced in the portal only. Okay, we won't be sending any email or any SMS regarding which branch you got. We will be announcing it in the application portal only. Next one is confirming means paying the full fee. First option, whenever you have been assigned a seat, you have kept three options, computer science, aeronautical, and mechanical. You got mechanical. First thing you need to do is accept to confirm the at least block that seat. The next thing you need to do is confirming, accepting. You need to accept by paying the partial fee. Confirm means by paying the full fee with the caution. Okay, so there are two options for you. You can accept and you can confirm. Whenever a seat has been assigned to you, first thing is you need to accept. Students who wants to participate in sliding also, they need to pay the initial fee. This is very much vital, students. All of you should remember, you want to participate in sliding option. So sliding option means you have got a seat, but you want it you want to move to a different branch or different fee slab. Then you need to pay minimum fees. That means 1 lakh fee to opt for sliding. This is very much vital. If you are not paying 1 lakh, you won't be allowed to use the sliding option and it won't be accepted. Your seat will not be blocked. Please remember that. Okay. Acceptance is very much vital and confirmation is like paying the full fee after all the three rounds are completed. Whenever the date we have given you, we will be giving you those things. This is very much vital. You can opt for sliding only after paying 1 lakh, which is fully refundable. Don't worry about it. Lot of students will be asking, will you refee or not? So if I pay 1 lakh or not, we will refund it. There is a withdrawal time also. We will be giving you the timeline. So it might be 2 or 3 weeks. So in that timeline, you can withdraw that thing. Okay, then the main thing you need to understand is what are the sliding options. Lot more people are confused now, what are the sliding options and all. And so what is the sliding people are talking about? The main thing is sliding to higher academic preference. That means you are allotted fourth preference in slab 4 and you wish to move to any higher academic preference and you are okay with any fees, then you can slide. Or slide to higher academic preference with fees greater than or equal to the current one. That is one sliding option. There are three sliding options available for all of you students. Okay, one is to a better branch, second is to a better fees, third is both combined. Okay, please understand it. This is as simple as that. Sliding is possible only after paying the 1 lakh, and the sliding you can do to get a better fee. Sliding is possible to get a better branch, and sliding is possible with the both of these options combined. It is as simple as that. Okay, so you will be given 3 days time to pay the initial fee or accepting the offer. Today, 20th, we are announcing some results means. So you will be given time until 23rd evening to complete the payment of partial tuition fees. That is very much vital. Okay, and after accepting the offer, you will be given 1 week time to pay the remaining tuition fee. Okay, and eligibility is must and should. Everybody, I am writing a betterment exam and all, so whatever it is there. So whenever the commencement of classes will be starting by October 1st, during that time, if you are unable to give the original certificates with the proper eligibility, your admission will be withheld. Eligibility is must and should. There is no leniency, and full refund will be available prior to class commencement. Class commencement date is October 1st, which we have announced. So this is what you should understand. This is very much vital. So 3 days will be given to you to pay the initial tuition fees, and 1 week to pay the full fee with caution deposit. Caution deposit will be 10,000. Okay, these are the important dates which you need to consider. Today is the registration which we are closing for the students. Candidates are advised to enter their best available JEE mains score by today evening, because we will be announcing JEE score today. Okay, PU score and the corresponding scorecard only, SAT or anything which you have. Today is the last day to update it, and no changes will be permitted after the allocation. If you are allotted a seat, then after that, even if you are written SAT again or if you are written JEE again, it won't be considered. And you will be given 3 days time to complete your payment process. That means the 5,000 fee payment for CSAP registration and all. And August 22nd will be the trial allotment, but we might announce it a little bit earlier also. Maybe tomorrow or day after we will be announcing it to you. Once we announce, we will inform you, and you will get to know to watch or get to know to view our trial allotment details only in your application portal. And on 25th August, first allotment will be there, or 24th August. These dates I will be announcing you where to look, the updated dates also. These are the dates and all. So by 1st October, classes will be starting. So the minimum eligibility which I have talked about is must and should. So you should have 60% aggregate of marks in mathematics, physics and chemistry. So that means all these three combined, and 55% in each subject. If you have applied through CSAP and paid 5,000 and not having this eligibility, we can't allow you to join. Before commencement of classes, you need to produce your original documents. Okay, and this is very much vital information. Today we are checking each and every student video feed. Lot more students have given their feedback, like lot more malpractice have happened and all. So we have been checking all the video feed, and our university will hold the right to block their admission if we found any discrepancies during the examination process. We are still checking. We might still block some of the students who have done malpractice and all. Okay, and if you have been blocked for ACCC, that means for malpractice, your ACCC marks are blocked. If you have JEE score, you can apply for that. Okay, please remember, JEE score, if you have, means you can apply for that. These are very much important dates. Tomorrow 9 p.m. if you really want to know which seat you are getting, because lot more students today are having confusion, like, sir, please tell me what branch I will be getting based on last year data and all. If you are really interested to know, please register for CSAP today. If you register for CSAP, you will get to know what branch will be allotted to you. And on 20th tomorrow evening 5 PM we will be publishing this trial allotment results. I encourage all the students to submit as many academic preferences as possible. Today lot more students are telling me I want only computer science. So I want only computer science. Please, I am putting only those options in trial allotment. I am encouraging all the students to submit maximum academic preferences, because you will at least get to know what branch will be offered. After trial allotment, you can edit your options. Okay, candidates are advised to submit more options to get the benefits of sliding. Okay, candidates can change the academic preferences already submitted after the trial allotment. Please note that after trial allotment, you'll be given time. That means tomorrow trial allotment results will be published, means on August 21st, until August 21st, you'll be given time to make changes in the seat allotment process. Okay, by August 24th, first allotment will be published. After this trial allotment changes are freezed, there are no more changes allowed after August 21st. Please keep it in mind, after August 21st, you can't make any changes to your academic preference. And August 24th, first allotment will be published. What branch and what fee slab you'll be getting, it will be published by August 24th afternoon. And if you have any issues during this process, counseling process, login issues, payment issues, refund issues, sliding issues, please note down these numbers. You can take a screenshot also, or note down these numbers, or this video is available to you. It's in YouTube. Go to this page, login issues, you can call this number 71777 in the end. And payment issues means if you are facing any payment issues during the initial fee payment or the full fee payment, you can call this number. Refund issues, refund will be taking more time. Today you have paid 5000 and you want your money back. Your 5000 will be only refunded only after the counseling process is completed. That means the counseling process will be completed by this August month end or September 15th. Until that time, refund won't be allowed for this 5000 if you are paid. Okay, sliding issues, that means you want to slide to a higher group or you want information about sliding, please call this number. So these helpline numbers are available for you today, and you can call them and you can ask them your doubts regarding this payment issues, refund issues and sliding issues. Please note down these numbers, and these numbers our counselors will be handling from in the working hours. You can call them at any time. Okay, and if any general queries you have, this number, of course, lot of students are already having, you can call to this number or mail to btech@amrita.edu. Okay, and still you are eager to know which branch and college you will be getting, only suggestion I will be doing is register for CSAP by today evening. You'll be getting to know in the trial allotment process and all. So what not to ask an admission counselor is, today every student is eager to know. I know you are very much eager to start your UG journey, undergraduate journey and all. Do not ask these questions, which branch and college I will get, how many seats are remaining, for my marks can I get CSE, what is the cutoff last year. So this we are not sharing information to our counselors also. They also don't know this information. Please do not ask this question. Ask questions related to the branch, like how good are the placements? So how is the infrastructure in each campus? So what kind of lab facilities are there? So ask these kind of questions if you are really eager to join Amrita. And what kind of research opportunities are there in each branch? These kind of questions, please ask to students. Okay. And the main thing which today you want to know is, I have shared in this slides. If you haven't got any information, please visit our website daily. So this is our website. Of course, all of you students might know this thing. We have given you clearly here sequence of seat allotment process. CSAP registration will continue till September 8th. Okay, candidates with JEE mains course can apply till 8th and all. Okay, why we have extended it till 8th also, we have explained here. And important thing which I want to tell all of you students is today, download this CSAP handbook. Why it is very much vital is if you click the CSAP handbook, it will give you a document like this. So this is called information on BTEC centralized seat allotment process. Okay, all the information, I mean the landline numbers of each campus and the branches available is given, eligibility criteria, annual fee structure. So what is the fees? So today, as I have told, 50% of seats, first 10% seats are filled in scholarship fees. One, scholarship fees two, cost 20%, seats are filled. Scholarship fees three, next 20%. And what is the caution deposit you need to pay? 10,000 is the caution deposit. Each and every information, like how much fees you need to pay and what are the branches offered. And a lot more students will be asking, this scholarship will be valid for the 4 years or 1 year. This scholarship will be valid for your first year. If you really want to continue your scholarship, these are the CGPAs you need to maintain. Okay, so you need to get into 8 above CGPA if you want to continue in slab 1. So 7.5 in slab 2. Likewise, CGPA cutoffs, what is required, also we have mentioned. And likewise, everything, what is the process used for seat allotment in 3 rounds, what we will be doing, and what are the important dates, like phase 3 seat allotment, from dates from to commencement of classes, after each allotment, what you need to do. What is the refund policy and everything we have mentioned, and the helpline numbers also we have mentioned in this document. Please go to the website, download this CSAP handbook. Please keep this handbook with you all the time. And if you just click beside that, you will get to know the important dates. So tomorrow, today, August 19th, 5 p.m., registration data will be taken for trial allotment. If you have applied after 5 p.m. today, you won't be able to know your trial allotment. Okay, today by 5 p.m. we have closed it, and tomorrow by afternoon you will be knowing about what kind of branch you are getting and what kind of fee structure you might be getting in the trial allotment. And on August 21st, until August 21st evening, you can make changes. You can make changes to that. By August 24th, the first allotment results will be announced. So we have given you guidelines also how you can utilize sliding and all. So if you faced any difficulty in between, don't worry about it. So our counselors are there to help you. So even you can mail us and you can call us at any point of time if you are facing any issue. Please be attentive in this 20 days, because do not blame somebody that you haven't received a mail, you haven't received a SMS. My main suggestion to all of you students today is go and visit the webpage continuously. Important updates are shared and information related to CSAP is shared. And if you have any doubts related to CSAP, mail it to btech@amrita.edu. I have given you a crisp about the engineering branches which we are offering today in Amrita, and also the process involved in the CSAP, what you need to do and all, and how many seats we are filling in the CSAP using scholarship. Every student today, please encourage your friends also to register for CSAP. They have any doubts and about what group and what branch they will check. And I encourage all of you students today to keep maximum options, maximum career academic preferences, because you have given an option to submit 31 academic preferences. Please submit all those things, because in trial allotment, you can get to know at least what branch you might get. Otherwise, people will be calling us saying, I haven't got any branch in the trial allotment. So what should I do now? So please keep maximum options possible so that it will be easy for you to understand and make changes accordingly before the first allotment. I hope all of you have understood this. And if you have any doubts, you can rewatch the video or talk with our counselors anytime. We will be able to help you during this entire process. Do not worry. So we won't leave you in the middle, and we won't ignoring you, your queries or anything at all. But do not ask trivial questions about what branch, prediction based questions. Even we also don't know what kind of branches and what kind of fee structures you will be getting and all. Based on last year's police tell, sir, please don't ask that. Please ask more information about the branch. Ask more information about infrastructure, about research opportunities, about placement opportunities for our counselors. Okay, all the best for all of you students. I encourage all of you to participate in the CSAP process and come out with flying colors, because today all of you are very much eager to start your journey as an undergraduate and enter and become part of Amrita University and Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham and all. So I congratulate all of you for achieving good ranks. Also, people who have done a lot more hard work to achieve these good ranks and all, you might be getting good fee slabs also if you have achieved good rank, good scholarship seats also. And people, please do not take this light. This process is very much vital. Everybody need to follow all the eligibility criteria. Everybody need to follow the rules by the university. Do not come to the university at this point of time and during this pandemic time. It is not advisable. And please make sure not to get deceived by other people by paying a hefty amounts regarding this fees and all. So we will be collecting all the fees through the application portal. By this time, all of you know what is your application portal is. All the information related to CSAP will be only posted there. Okay, all the best for all of you students. With this, I will stop this session. Maybe we will meet you again tomorrow. Tomorrow we are starting a Zoom session. I don't know how many people have checked the web page. Tomorrow onwards, we are starting a Zoom session in our website. Please go to our website and check there. Every day from morning 11 to 1. That means every working day, Monday to Friday, you can just log in into Zoom and talk with our counselors face to face. From morning 11 to 1. So that Zoom link is available to you. It's available in the website. You can just go and click there and interact with our counselors face to face daily. Okay. With this, I will end this session. Thank you everyone for attending this, and I'll be looking forward to see you again in the coming days. Thank you.